the Hindus are having vegetables. Then the philosophy changed. They said, see, we agree. The plants are living creatures, but the plants can't feel pain. Therefore, eating vegetable is a lesser crime as compared to non-veg. Science has further developed, and today we come to know that plants can too feel pain. Though the nervous system is ill-developed, but even the plants can feel pain. We can't hear it. So, the whole logic has been proved false. There was a person who had a very long discussion with me regarding veg and non-veg. And he said that, see brother, the plants have got about 2 to 3 senses. The animals, they have got 5 senses. Therefore, killing a plant is a lesser crime. For the sake of argument, we agree with him that the plants have got 3 senses and the animal has got 5 senses. I pose a question to him, that suppose your brother, if he's born blind and deaf, he can't see and he can't hear, and if he grows up, if a criminal comes and kills him, will you go to the judge and tell him that, oh my lord, oh my judge, please give the criminal less punishment because my brother could not see and hear? In fact, you'll tell the judge that you should give him a bigger punishment. Usne masoom ko mara hua hai. He has killed an innocent person. If he wanted, he could have tried and killed me. Maybe I would have given a tough fight. So the logic does not work here. Quran says, of the meat of the cattle, you can eat. Further on, some people may say that you Muslim, you are ferocious people, you are violent people. Because you have non-veg, you start behaving like the animals. You are violent and you are terrorist. I agree with the brother that whatever food you have, it has an effect on your behavior. But we should also remember that our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, may Allah be pleased with him, may peace be upon him, he said that forbidden for food are all carnivorous animals. All animals that have canine teeth and claws, including the cat family, the rats, etc., and the birds which have got claws, all these are prohibited. The only one which is halal are the herbivorous animal. So I do agree with you that if you have lion and tiger, you start behaving violent and ferocious. But we Muslims, we have goat, cow, sheep. We are as peaceful as the cow, the goat and the sheep. If you read the Quran, it is mentioned in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 96, that lawful for you is the pursuit of water games, and their food is lawful for you. Means you can have all types of seafood, including its mention in Surah Nahl, chapter number 16, verse number 14, that the seafood, the flesh, you can have which is tender and fresh. I start my talk by quoting a verse from the Quran, from Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 3, which says, حُرَّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَيْتُتُ وَالْدَّمُ وَلَحْمُ الْخِنْزِيرِ وَمَا أُهِلَّ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ. That forbidden for you, for food, dead meat, blood, the flesh of swine, and any food on which the name of anyone besides Allah has been invoked. These 4 food are prohibited. Let's analyze each one of them. The first is dead meat. Science tells us today that if any animal dies of a disease or of old age, and if you have that meat, it is unhygienic for you, and there are chances you will acquire disease. And the verse continues that even the animal which has been strangled or which has been killed by a violent blow or by a headlong fall or by going to death or which has been partly eaten by wild animals, all these are forbidden. We in Islam, before having any animal, it's compulsory that we do zabah. We sacrifice according to the Islamic law. That's the reason that we cut the jugular vein and the carotid artery, the food pipe and the windpipe, while slaughtering. There was a Sikh brother, we have Sikhs in India who have the turbans, they come from the Punjab side, they believe in jhatka, in stunning death. So he was having an argument with a Muslim brother and he said, why do you all torture the animal? The way your Muslims cut, he bleeds to death and it is very painful. It is better to kill it in one stroke, just above the head. So the Muslim brother, who was not well versed with science, he gave a very witty reply. He said, you are Sikhs, you are cowards, you are a buzdil, you attack from behind. We Muslims, we are brave, we are courageous, we attack from the front. Anyway, this is not the reason why we do Zabah. The scientific reason that why we do Zabah is that during the sacrifice, according to the Islamic law, we have to take the name of Allah. As is mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Nahl, chapter number 6, verse number 121, that we have to take the name of Allah. And then we cut the carotid artery and the jugular vein, the windpipe and the food pipe. Now when we cut these vessels, the animal does not die on the spot. Whereas in the other style, that is stunning to death or severing the head, the animal dies on the spot. In this method, people say it is more painful. Actually, it's the opposite. In stunning, the moment you give a blow on the head, the animal is stunned, but still it feels pain when it actually dies. In our method, the moment you sever the vessels, the blood supply to the nervous system is blocked. And thus, the animal cannot feel pain. It does struggle. That is due to the gushing forth of the blood from the vessels. The heart is yet functioning. The heart yet pumps the blood. And most of the blood in the body of the animal is flown out. And the second criteria which is forbidden is blood. And science tells us today that blood is a very good media for germ and bacteria as well as for disease. That's the reason when we do Zabah, most of the blood flows out and the meat that we have is more hygienic. And besides that, the meat which is sacrificed according to the Islamic law remains fresh for a longer time as compared to meat cut by stunning.